Hey guys, I'm Whitney Ullman here with Brandon and Tim of Brantim Entertainment, which I love that name. It's pretty cool. And they're going to be bringing the Atlantic City Celebrity Convention to the ACX1 Studios from July 25th to the 28th, right in Atlantic City. Like, this is so cool, and I'm so excited to have you on here. How are you guys doing?
Good.
Awesome.
Good. Thank you for having
Thank
us.
you for having us.
So, normally when I'm on a Zoom, I put a fake background. But since I have now a room with my celebrity wall and I'm interviewing with you, I just figured it's a good background. Thank you. So,
Beautiful.
so cool. So for me personally, being in Atlantic City and from Atlantic City and, promoting Atlantic City, to have a convention such as this coming to town is so awesome. And to use that space of ACX1 is a huge project in itself. So why don't we just talk about how it came about, and then we'll go into more questions about what people can expect.
So we have been researching different conventions, comic cons, anime cons, sports cards and collectible cons, and we always knew that we wanted to do something like this. We did a lot of research across the country, not just in the market. I mean, Brandon had already been going to a lot of cons in the area because he's obviously from the area. Me being from Massachusetts, there really isn't much of a market up there other than sports cards and collectibles and anime. But anyway, I've gone to we've gone to places like Houston, Kansas City, Dallas, Texas, and even Florida, and looked at different ways that they do different things. And we're like, you know what, we can do this. We have a lot of connections with celebrity guests and also celebrity reps, and through our through filmmaking, that we're like, you know what, let's try to put something together. And then that kind of got sidetracked. But then when the guys at ACX1 Studios, who are friends with Brandon, said, hey, we would like some more events here. You guys want to do one here? And we looked at the venue and we're like,
How
absolutely.
can he
Because
say no
number
to
one,
that?
there is no like venue like this. Well, in the con circuit anyway, it's either a stifled, sweaty, smelly, arena or a convention center or a VFW hall
Right,
or
a hall, right.
banquet hall. Exactly. So we said, look at this place. Like, this is, there's so much potential here to, utilize this, the aesthetic that's already here, and then what will also be, what they're building there. We're like, let's absolutely do this. It's one of a kind venue, obviously, and yeah, they said, hey, let's do this. And then Brandon and I did some digging and more digging, and how we could actually pull it off, and what kind of different experiences we could offer the public. And then coupled with, hey, let's not just make this a horror con or an anime con. Let's just make this this first one like an everything con. So there's actors and actresses from all different walks of life, wrestlers, musicians, everything. So it's quite the mix.
Like, experience is kind of what we're branding for it, just to give a little bit of everything. Kind of, we call it our WrestleMania of conventions to start off, and then we're gonna kind of branch off every 6 months and do kind of like specific genre cons, like an animation con, an action theme con, and a comedy con. So just different things to kind of just kind of branch out to more specific audiences. But this one is the first one we wanted, like Tim said, an everything con to give a little bit, even soap stars and people like every reality shows. Like, we have some people from Netflix, Squid Game, The Challenge. So like I said, giving a little bit of everything to kind of pull in different audiences from the public.
How is it going to work? Is it going to be where they're standing behind a booth, or do we get to actually just mix and mingle?
Well, it's how this works is that they'll have tables for autographs and photo ops. But I mean, you can go up, talk to them, like pick out which photos they have to get autographed and kind of meet and greet with them a little bit. And then there are industry panels we're going to have throughout the weekend where we'll have specific ones for like the cast of Roswell, for the Walking Dead universe.
Oh, cool.
C. Thomas Howe, like, we're having a special screening of The Outsiders on Sunday afternoon, that he'll be in attendance doing a meet and greet and a Q&A. So, like, and then other experiences that we're still announcing that are going to be huge for fans as well over the next couple of weeks. So again, trying to build on experiences, but there will be opportunity even in our VIP parties. Like, a lot of celebrities will be there to be able to mingle with. So that's the thing we're pushing to, if you want to actually meet and greet and have a drink with C. Thomas Howe or Pam Grier or any of these awesome people on our lineup, then come to our VIP parties, because that's where you might have even more time to kind of mingle with them.
So talk to us about these celebrities. I know we talked about, like, I was just talking about Pam Grier, Stacey Dash. Who are you both most excited to meet that's going to be there? Like, is there someone there that you're like, damn, I can't believe we got this person?
For me, Pam Grier is a big one because, again, growing up, I mean, she was an icon of cinema and television. And when we got that confirmation, that was awesome. C. Thomas Howe is a huge for me, too, because my all-time favorite film is The Outsiders. It's the first book I ever read as a young kid, and I was just captivated by the movie. I still watch it every year. So that's huge for me, being he was kind of the lead in that great ensemble. So that's big for me, and it's a lot, some of the people I have the fortune to know ahead of time, so I'm already good friends with a handful of people like Mark Weber and Teresa Palmer and a few others. But again, for me, C. Thomas Howe is huge, and actually I love his music too. I actually do follow Tommy Howell and his band because they're amazing, and they're going to perform on kickoff night of Thursday the 25th on stage there at ACX1. So for me, like, that's huge for me just to be able to break bread with Ponyboy. So
I'd say Bret Hart. I know Brandon's already met him, but I have not. So this will be huge for me. And then Greg Nicotero. I've been a huge horror fan my whole life. And he was, you know, he had his hands in pretty much with special effects and so on, every single thing I've ever loved about horror. And then obviously The Walking Dead, and then literally the whole Walking Dead cast that we have. I mean, I'm a huge, you know, horror guy and Walking Dead guy. So everybody, we have like 8 of them right now, people of that universe. So
that's awesome.
That'd be cool.
That's awesome. Well, I mean, I certainly appreciate you guys doing this and bringing it to Atlantic City. So before we wrap up, it would be cool to do more of a specific rundown. Do you want to talk to us about how, like, you know, the 25th at night is this event, 26th, 27th, 28th, and kind of let us know the order of events?
So Thursday is the kickoff party. We start off at 6 p.m. with the red carpet until 7. So for all the celebrities that will be there that day, we can't guarantee that every one of them will be there the day before, but it will be between 6 and 7. And then at 7:30 to 8:30, we're going to have the live performance from C. Thomas Howell and his band. And then from 9 p.m. till 1 a.m. that evening, we will have the VIP after party with music and light snacks and drinks and whatnot in the fourth floor. And then on Friday, we have the just convention itself.
Friday, we start 2 p.m. We start a little bit earlier that day, and we go till 8. Okay. And that's going to be the autograph signing and picture taking, professional photo ops. Also, we're going to start the industry panels that day. We'll have 3 of them each day. And around the same thing that night at 9 o'clock to 1 a.m., we're going to do the VIP parties. And we're going to do that each night, Friday and Saturday, throughout the event. And then, like I said, we are going to be announcing some other special, like, experiences that we've kind of briefly talked about on other podcasts and different things, but we're just solidifying some of the logistics of them with the studio and the clients that we're dealing with.
I'm personally so excited about it, and I know people can get tickets for it, and then I'm guessing there's tickets to each experience, so if you want to come for the weekend, or if you want to come per day, or if you want to come to the panels.
Yeah, so the weekend, so we have a single day passes, weekend passes. The panels, they're included. As long as you have entry into the building that day or the weekend, you'll be able to see whatever panels you want for free. The only things that are extra really are the after parties on Friday and Saturday. And then after the convention's over on Sunday, that's when the special screening of The Outsiders is. That's separate. That's separate from the event. It's at the event, but it's separate from the event. You have to pay for the screening ticket, which is $20, or you can pay $40 for the meet and greet with Tommy Howell after the Q&A and screening of The Outsiders on Sunday. That's separate.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, it's great. It's great that people can do that. So no matter what they're interested in, they can choose that experience and they can do it. So you guys have a website.
We have one more thing. There's more. So we actually have the ultimate VIP pass too, which is pretty much all encompassing, for $400. But the total of like the Thursday kickoff party pass, which gets you into everything Thursday, plus the weekend pass, plus the Friday after party pass, plus the Saturday after party pass, all that included for $400, which is actually, I think, like $700 total, really. So you save like $300.
That's cool. That's great. And that's like a fun experience. If you're, especially if you're coming to Atlantic City for the whole weekend, you have something to do every day and you can meet your favorite artists. And the fact, how many celebrities are you going to have in total?
I think we're around 50 right now. We had kind of aimed in the beginning around 30, but it kind of like adding to different experiences. Like we kind of kept adding to The Walking Dead, and then Roswell got bigger. And there's also some links we're doing right now. Like we just did a cool link for General Hospital of Kelly Tebald and Perry Shen, who were an awesome duo on that show for years. So, and that's going to be a big panel. It's going to be a great time for soap fans. So like I said, just kind of giving experiences that people are going to remember forever, like even with the professional photo ops. And also anybody, on another note, anybody who's interested in rooms, like we have a Tropicana link up for special rates there. We're working on rates with other places too that are attached to Caesars. And anybody's interested in vending, they can reach out to Dennis at BrantimENT.com. They're interested in sponsorships, they can reach out to info@BrantimENT.com. And yeah, because we're looking for just a lot of people to assist us on. This is a Herculean effort, but takes a lot to get through this, but yeah, it's going to be an epic summer weekend in Atlantic City.
That's amazing. And you're right, it is going to be epic, and it does take a village. Like, we need to all help each other and make this happen, because there's a lot of people that I know will be interested in coming to this. So I hope to, you know, get this out to all the right people, and we'll sell some tickets and get some vendors and sponsors for you guys. So we appreciate it. And I know people can buy tickets at brantim.realms.tv. Is that the only place to get it? Correct. And I'll put that on the screen, brantim.realms.tv. Is there anything else that you want to tell fans and people that would want to come before?
100%. Well, first and foremost, we really wanted to do this for Atlantic City, first and foremost. We've gone to conventions in Atlantic City, but we really felt that there's something, like we wanted to do something special, and we wanted to do something special enough where we can continue to do it and continue to offer cool experiences and do something different than the other, you know, conventions of past or whatnot that I've done. Because obviously there's awesome, amazing concerts there all the time. There's amazing comedy shows all the time in Atlantic City. We just want to kind of like, you know, do something for that and do something to give people a reason to come to Atlantic City at any given time. And there always is, because there's always something going on, some show, something. But, and then obviously in the summertime, it's always amazing there. But we wanted to bring something to it, and in our appreciation for every time that we've gone to Atlantic City and had a great time. So.
Absolutely. Shout out to ACX1 Studios, all the great people over there. They're wonderful in helping us do this. J&J Authentics are our official mail-in order company. They're good friends of ours. So yeah, like you said, it takes a village to make these things happen, but we're all banding together. Thanks to Crystal Bailey. It's been amazing, like, setting this up for us. And yeah, and just like I said, some other awesome people that they know who they are and how much we appreciate them. So, but thank you to everybody. Thank you to you, Whitney, for doing this today.
Yeah, of course. I appreciate you guys.
Yeah, thank you, Whitney.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you for doing this for Atlantic City. And guys, you can get your tickets at brantim.realms.tv. The web address will be on the screen. And I will see you guys in July 25th to 28th at the ACX1 Studios. Thank you so much, guys.